We are here today with Octavia Melly, famed cellist and musical delight of the classical scene.
Really? You're too kind.
Miss Melody, or can I call you Octavia?
Octavia would be fine. Just don't call me anything shorter. Octi or Tavy or the like. I do find it quite annoying. My roommate calls me Tavy all the time specifically because she knows how it irritates me.
Ah yes, your roommate. Tell me, do you recognize the mayor in this picture?
Yes, that's her. That's my roommate, Vinyl Scratch. I believe it was taken at a concert on her latest tour. Canterlot Gardens, maybe?
Very good. It was indeed.
Yes, well, I was backstage at the time, and it's a very imposing building. One doesn't forget a place like that easily.
Backstage, eh? Very privileged. How long have you and Vinyl known each other, if you're getting backstage access at a concert on a sellout tour by one of Equestria's hottest DJs?
Well, we met at college. We took musical history and sat next to each other. If you knew Vinyl, you'd think she'd be slacking off and constantly borrowing my notes. But actually, she was the star student. There's nothing she doesn't know about the history of music from Renaissance-era Equestria. Although, I guess that makes a little more sense now. First hoof knowledge and all. Despite our differences, we became close friends. We even decided to share an apartment after we graduated. I thought that nothing was a secret between us, and that I could give her my complete trust.
And what exactly changed that trust between you?
Recently, she revealed herself to be something I could never imagine her being. And yet, it makes sense. I guess, deep down, I knew something was different about her. I just didn't think. I mean, you don't, do you? That's not the sort of place one's mind immediately goes when one's friend exhibits such odd behavior. To be honest, I thought it was maybe drugs or something. I mean, she moves in circles, I don't. Social groups on her music scene are very different than mine. You hear all sorts of stories. I mean, she always assured me she wasn't that stupid, but then things would happen. She'd do things or have reactions that weren't normal.
If Vinyl had told you before you discovered, do you think you would have had a different reaction?
I don't think so, no.
If she returned from her recent self-imposed absence, what would you do?
Well, I would accept her differences and help in any way I can. After all, she may be a I feel silly even saying it. Creatures of the dark and things that go bump in the night are just storybook monsters, you know? To think that I've been such close friends with an actual vampire for all this time. But she is my closest friend. That hasn't changed. I would want to help her, to support her, and to just be there for her. She's very important to me. Very important.
If she was listening right now, and you could say one thing to her, what would it be?
Vinyl, come home. Please. I'm worried about you. Please, let me know that you're all right. That you aren't hurt, or... I'm sorry, I can't.
That's perfectly okay, Octavia. Thank you very much for speaking with me, and taking the time to be here.